Dear students, welcome to NIOS Studio. I am Amrit G. Kumar, working as Associate Professor in the Department of Education of Central University of Kerala. Today, we will be discussing about midday meal scheme practiced in Indian schools. Midday meal scheme is a school meal program of the Government of India designed to improve the nutritional status of school-aged children nationwide. I am sure that midday meal scheme is not a new terminology for any of the students, because all the schools all over India practice or provide midday meals to the children who attend the schools regularly. Midday meal scheme is one of the world's largest nutrition program also. Nowhere in the world you can see such a largest scheme where children are fed with nutrition and with necessary food for their daily life to attend the school. Midday meal program extends to nearly 12 crore children in India. Across 12.65 lakh schools, midday meal school program is practiced. Now you will be able to identify the extent of the extent of growth of midday meals program in India. If we look into the history, we can see that history of midday meal scheme dates back to 1925. That means even before independence of India. It was launched for the disadvantaged children in the Madras Municipal Corporation in 1925. So we can see that midday meal program has originated from Madras, Tamil Nadu, in the year 1925 for the children who attend the school during 1925. Gradually, midday meal program gained popularity, and by 1991, it was implemented in 12 states in India. Subsequently, in 1995, the scheme was launched as a centrally sponsored scheme covering 2,408 blocks in the country. You know, it was a wonderful program which was started before independence in Madras Presidency, and then later on different states picked it up, and gradually the central government had initiated it as a centrally sponsored scheme, and thereby it has become a national program all over India. In 2001, every government and government aided primary school was to be served a prepared midday meal with a minimum content of 300 calories of energy and 8 to 12 gram protein per day for a minimum of 200 days in an academic year. That means that midday meal program covers almost all the days of school attendance for a child, for a student. Every day, in spite of the regional differences, in spite of their gender differences and various other difficulties or differences, a student is entitled for midday meals program in India. Let us look into the extension and revision of midday meal program. The midday meal program has extended to a large terrain in the years that when we look back. The scheme was extended in the year 2002. To cover not only children studying in government and government-aided and local body schools, but also children studying in education guarantee scheme and alternative and innovative education centers. So it means that if a student who is attending some kind of educational program, he or she will be covered under midday meal program. So it has become an almost right for the children to claim for midday meal if he or she attends a school or an educational institution. In September 2004, the scheme was further revised to provide for central assistance for cooking cost at rupees 1 per child per school to cover cost of pulses, vegetables, cooking oil, fuel, wages and remuneration payable to personnel or amount payable to agency responsible for cooking. So it means that midday meal school program has received extensive support from the government for cooking and for buying vegetables and buying materials for cooking. And in all the ways, midday meal program has become a fully established and fully supported scheme in India. The nutritional norm for upper primary stage was fixed at 700 calories and 20 grams of protein, and at present, the scheme was extended to all areas across the country from 1/4/2008 onwards. By 2010-11, about 11.36 crore children in elementary schools has been covered, spanning 12.63 lakhs institutions in the country. Now you will be able to understand the extent of growth of midday meal program in India. It means that it covers almost all the government institutions, all the government aided institutions and other institutions which are supported by government in some form of education where children attends. Let us look into National Food Security Act 2013. The midday meal scheme is covered by National Food Security Act 2013, also called the Right to Food Act. So, the National Food Security Act 2013 is also called as Right to Food Act. It is an act of Parliament of India which aims to provide subsidized food grains to approximately 2/3 of India's 1.2 billion people. So, it's a very huge and gigantic program that Government of India has undertaken with a constitutional support. So, the National Food Security Act 2013 was signed into law on 12th September of 2013, retroactive to 5th July 2013. The midday meal scheme and the integrated child development services scheme are universal in nature, whereas the public distribution systems will reach about 2/3 of the population, that is 75% in rural areas and 50% in the urban areas. So, it's an extensive program. Let us look into the implementation models of midday meal school program. There are three kinds of model which we can say. Midday meal is implemented as a decentralized model. Another model is a centralized model. And yet another model is an international assistance model. Let us look into what is decentralized model. So, decentralized model is the most widespread practice in midday meal program. In decentralized model, the meals or food are cooked on site by local cooks and in decentralized model, meals are cooked on site by local cooks or helpers or self-help groups. This system has the advantage of being able to serve local cuisine, providing jobs in the area and minimizing the wastage of food materials. It also allows for better monitoring by parents and teachers and so on, because the food is cooked within the campus or in the local area or the nearby vicinity of the teachers and schools. The inadequate infrastructure such as kitchen sheds, utensils, etc. can lead to hygienic problem and sometimes accidents in case of decentralized model. So, I was talking about some negative aspect of decentralized model. Since there are positive aspects of decentralized model, which we have seen that students can enjoy the local cuisines and the teachers and parents can monitor the preparation of the cooking and preparation of the food. These are the positive models, but at the same time, in many of the rural sectors in India, there are inadequate infrastructure. Say, for example, in some cases, foods were prepared in open spaces without much hygienic care at all. And in some cases, utensils were not washed properly and no proper care for hygienic hygiene has been paid, no proper hygienically filtered water being used for the cooking of the food for the children. So in both cases, we can see that there are both positive and negative aspects of decentralized model. When we look into the centralized model, we can see that an external organization cooks and delivers the meals to the schools, mostly through public-private partnership. So this is an important characteristic of a centralized model. In a city or in an urban sector, we can see that it's not possible for the people to cook at their local level because the space of the school may not be limited, may not be available, may not be splendidly available for cooking and so on. So in such cases, a centralized place will be identified where cooking will be done. So usually such cooking will be done in private-public partnerships. Centralized kitchens are seen more in urban areas, as I told you earlier, we discussed it earlier, where density of schools is high, so that transporting food is financially viable option. This is another important reason for a centralized kitchen, because schools are located in density. Densely populated schools are available in urban areas and densely populated schools are available. Density of schools are too high in cases of urban sectors. In such cases, most of the schools may not have space for preparing food, and at the same time, they will not be in urban sectors. The density of the schools will be higher than that of a village sector. In most of the urban schools, there will be lack of space for preparing the food. In such cases, a common center or a common place will be identified, and thereby cooking can be undertaken at this public space or a common space for a number of schools. This common place will be cooking food and it will be transporting to the different schools, because this transportation won't cost very much, mainly because the schools are located in close vicinities. Advantages of centralized kitchens include ensuring better hygienic and large scale cooking. So this is an important advantage of centralized kitchen. Large scale cooking and hygienicity can be maintained because it has been done in a professional way. So also automation process also is very good when it is done in a centralized way. Various non-governmental organizations such as Akshaya Patra Foundation, Ekta Shakti Foundation, Nandi Foundation and Jai Ghee Humanitarian Society and People's Forum are some examples who provide centralized support for cooking in schools which are located in urban sectors. This system had disadvantages also. The centralized cooking system has many disadvantages also. Food quality can be a problem in many of the centralized midday meal program, cooking programs. Even teachers feel helpless and do not know whom to complain to when the food provided did not meet the required quality. So this is an important disadvantage of decentralized cooking of midday meal program. When the quality of a food dip down, the teachers will become helpless because it is not being done under the monitoring of the teachers. Parents cannot do anything because it is done in a centralized form, in a centralized area, in a highly professionalized form. So they do not have access to these centralized agencies who cook the food. So when there is a problem, often teachers looks helpless and seems helpless, whom to control, what to do and so on. So this is an important limitation of the centralized cooking of midday meal program. The Ministry of Human Resource Development reported that 95% of the tested meal samples prepared by non-governmental organizations in Delhi did not meet nutritional standards in 2010-12. This is a snippet of what happens in a centralized midday meal cooking program. This need not be true for everywhere, but still this should be taken as a serious sample from where Delhi we have tested that the quality of the midday meal program did not meet the essential standards. International assistance model is a third model which we have discussed. The first one is decentralized, second one is centralized, and the third one is international assistance. International voluntary and charity organizations have been providing extensive support for the midday meal program in India. For example, Church World Service, CWS, which was founded in 1946 and is a cooperative ministry of 37 Christian denominations and communions, have provided milk powder to Delhi and Madras Municipal Corporation. This foundation was instituted in 1946, and they have been providing extensive support to the centers where midday meals program is being practiced. CARE, that means that Cooperative for Assistance and Relief Everywhere. It was formerly known as Cooperative of American Remittance to Europe. CARE, Cooperative for Assistance and Relief Everywhere, which was formerly known as Cooperative for American Remittances to Europe. They also provide extensive support for the midday meal program. CARE provide soya meal, bulgur wheat, and vegetable oils and so on for supporting the midday meal program in India. UNICEF is another important international agency which support midday meal program in India. UNICEF has provided high protein foods and educational support to the midday meal program that we see in India. Next, we look into the monitoring of the midday meal scheme program. There are different levels at which monitoring of midday meal program take place. First one is national level. National level monitoring is done in terms of distribution of funding, distribution of the different materials which are essential for the midday meal program, and policy decisions for the midday meal programs. State level, at a lower level from the national level, also provide financial support and policy supports for the midday meal program. District level is mainly involved in the execution of the policies which are constituted by the state and national bodies. So at district level, these policies are planned out and chalked out and implemented at local level. Municipal level has the influence of, or the municipal level has the capacity to monitor the midday meal program at its sites. Say, for example, they can inspect the school level, they can inspect the midday meal cooking kitchens and so on. When it comes to the block level, they also do have the capacity to inspect and monitor the school level and local level midday meal program. Village is another important example of monitoring, because village committees and village level monitoring is more effective when compared to the district level, municipal level, block level inspections. When it comes to the school level inspection, this is the most important and most effective way of monitoring the midday meal school program, where teachers themselves can become the monitors of the midday meals program. They decide the menu, they decide how it can be cooked, they decide the hygienicity level of the midday meal program and so on. So the most effective monitoring level happens at school level, where policy level and funding level monitoring happens at national level. There are several committees formed at national level, state level, district level, municipal level, mandal level, panchayat level, subcommittee and so on for implementation and for monitoring of the midday meal program. For the schools, school management and development committee or parent teacher association monitor in many of the schools about the midday meal program. The meetings are conducted sometimes quarterly, monthly, fortnightly, as and when it is required at school level. Government of India review missions on midday meal scheme comprising members from the central government, state governments, UNICEF and the office of the Supreme Court. The scheme is independently monitored twice a year. Let us look into the impact of midday meal scheme in India. Midday meal scheme has become a real booster for student enrollment. The enrollment of the student has become increased. The enrollment of the student has increased due to midday meal scheme, as per our experience. Also, midday meal scheme helps to promote student attendance in schools. Those students who are coming from the poor localities, poor economic background, do attend the schools for the midday meal. And this has become an important criterion, an important strategy for the schools to improve their attendance. So in that way, midday meal has become a great impact upon the education system. Midday meal scheme serves as an incentive not only for the children but also for the parents, as it has an implicit subsidy in it, because the parents need not have to prepare food if both the parents are going for job or for work. So in that cases, they can send their children to the school, or they can give their children to the school, so that schools will take care of the food and other necessities of the children. Midday meal school again attracts children who are otherwise reluctant to go to school. There are some children who don't want to attend the school because of their several reasons, financial and psychological and several other reasons. But midday meal school has become an important tool for inviting the attention of the children and thereby calling them to the schools. Nutritional impact, which helps students in their learning, is another important. Another important aspect of midday meal scheme is that it has improved the nutritional level of the children in India. Also, it helps to solve deficiency related diseases that are endemic in some areas of the country. So in all these aspects, midday meal school program has become a great support to our Indian education system. Let us conclude. We have seen the history of midday meal school program, which was originated in 1925 in Madras Presidency, even before our independence. Also, we have discussed about the aims of midday meal scheme. And also, we have seen three models of implementation of midday meal scheme. They were central, state, decentralized, central, and international assistance model. And also, we have seen the way how to monitor and evaluate the midday meal scheme by various agencies. Dear students, I hope you understood about the midday meal scheme program in India, and I wish you all the best. I thank you all.